Hi there. So I'm not a scientist, I'm a designer. I come from a design background, and I got involved in Nano because I realized it wasn't just going to revolutionize my industry, but it's going to affect everything else as we know it. So let's look at just one factor of nanotechnology, and that's nano coatings. So we know the lotus leaf cleans itself because water bees are running off the leaf, stays dry, cleans off any dirt. And nanotechnology, we can actually now replicate that coating on any surface, on wood, on stone, on fabrics, paper, your dog, whatever. So 10 ideas of what we can do with just that one invention. So we've got an amazing local design culture. Instead of competing with price against China, let's create products that are incredibly functional. So the cup at the top there has been coated, one off hasn't. We don't need soap to clean anymore, just water. We can make electronics completely waterproof. That's actually one of my cell phones that I put underwater. We can make textiles completely waterproof and stainproof even after you wash it. So that means we can start going back towards natural materials instead of using plastic for disposable cutlery or packaging, or even polyester or nylon-based fabrics. We can use synthetic fabric like hemp and cotton mixes. Okay, you can even spray this technology on a leaf. On the right, it's been coated. The left, it hasn't. You can see it stopped fungal growth. You can apply it on seeds. You can see the germination rate is much better on the right. So how do you sell sand to Arabs? Well, you sell them nano sand. Easy. This sand has been coated with nano glass coating, and you can see it actually agglomerates when it goes in the water, but it stays dry at all times, as you can see at the top. So you take the sand, you put it a meter under the surface of like a situation like this, you start irrigation, and you might even be able to grow rice. Actually, they are growing rice already with this technique. Same technology can be used to prevent diseases. It kills bacteria, basically. So when you have a sanitation issue like this, all you need to do is coat the toilet seats. So in a country where a lot of kids are dying from something as simple as diarrhea, all you need to do is just coat the surfaces, and then people won't be spreading diseases. Safe and energy-efficient housing. Corrugated iron is obviously a terrible heat insulator. So if you coat this on the inside of these houses, you'll actually increase efficiency by 35%. Plus, the coating is also flame retardant. So that'll go a long way in preventing township fires. The technology can actually purify the air. So they've used this and they coated 5 square meters of concrete in Italy, and it's actually increased the air quality by 45% because of the photocatalytic properties and how it reacts with the sun. So imagine all our buildings were coated in this. Okay, street art. This is something that I did on my cousin's wall. She doesn't know yet. You can see what I've written now is completely dry, and everything around it I sprayed off with water is still wet. That little bead that you sort of see running down there, that's what we saw in the lotus leaf earlier. So the next time when you go and spray in Cape Town, the cops come around, just tell them it's water. And then next day when it rains, yeah. Finally, you can waterproof your dog. I'm sure he'll love you for it. I've tried it. Don't worry, it is safe. So my challenge to you, what will you nano? Thank you.